It's a pleasure to be here in this co-porter's retreat promoted by the Review and Herald. I'm glad to be here. And my name is Wellington. I'm Brazilian. I'm a co-porter like all of you are.
Amen.
And I am a mechanical engineer graduating from MIT. This MIT, I should clarify, is not the MIT from Massachusetts, but the MIT from Brazil, Governador Valadares. It's a good school, and I was a good student, and good professional too. But the point is, I graduated in 1982 from that school, and then I worked for several years in Brazil and came to the US about 19 years ago. But what I'm here to talk to you about is about this book entitled The Plot. This book talks about dinosaurs, but having a different approach. It's not the same approach that science gives to this subject. It's a religious approach. It's based on Bible texts and Ellen G. White's texts. So, the dinosaurs, did God create them or were they just the result of Lucifer's tampering with nature? That was a question that was for a long time in my mind. The plot proposed a different explanation for the dinosaurs appearing on Earth. A story told in 10 chapters and over 22,000 words encompasses a variety of subjects such as genetics, anatomy, religion, philosophy, sociology, and paleontology, the science of fossils. Ellen G. White wrote, "Every species of animals which God had created was preserved in the ark. The confused species which God did not create, which were the result of amalgamation, were destroyed by the flood." And that text, you can find it in the Spiritual Gifts, page 75. Ellen White comments on Satan's power to interfere with nature. She says, in the parable of the sower, the question was asked the master, "Didst not thou sow good seed in thy field? How then hath it tares?" The master answered, "An enemy hath done this. All tares are sown by the evil one. Every noxious herb is of his sowing, and by ingenious methods of amalgamation, he has corrupted the earth with tares." Selected Message, Book 2, page 228, and Matthew chapter 13, verse 24 to 30. You find the parable of the sower in that text. Amalgamation reference. The term genetics was coined in 1909 by a British biologist, William Bateson. So by the time when Ellen G. White wrote about the flood, the term genetics did not exist as yet. So the term, other related terminologies such as genes, clone, genetic engineering, DNA code, did not exist in 1864 when Ellen White wrote about the flood occurred in Noah's time. She could only have spoken about the mixture of different species using the known terminology in the latest part of her lifetime. Charles Darwin himself never used the word amalgamation in the course of explaining his theory in 1859. Satan's tampering with nature. According to Mrs. White's statement, Satan had been tampering with nature by making amalgamation, mixture, among men and among beasts. If the word amalgamation means the breeding of two species to obtain a third one, not all of them will blend, except in a few cases, with the resultant species being unfertile and not able to perpetuate itself by generation of offspring. The only way Lucifer could have mixed up different species such as reptiles, mammals, and birds was recurring to the clever manipulation of DNA molecule and its code. Does the Bible refer to dinosaurs? In the Bible, we find reference to huge animals, behemoth and leviathan, that some erroneously refer to as dinosaurs. And you can find those passages, the reference. Behemoth is the plural form of the Hebrew word behema, translated as cattle. Dinosaurs were land animals. A cattle-like animal seems most likely to be a mammal, not a mixture of reptile, mammal, and bird, as naturalists and paleontologists have described the dinosaurs. Some Bible commentators admit that the Leviathan could be a crocodile, while others argue that it could be a pliosaur, a huge aquatic animal. Dinosaurs were land animals, not sea monsters. Why was the plot written? And that's the main reason. I'm going to explain it to you now. It presents a new idea about the origin and demise of dinosaurs founded on two basic reasons. First, science has been unable so far to present a convincing evidence that would put an end to the long debate about the origin of life in our planet. The second reason relates to the very nature of those huge beasts. The nature of the huge beasts, the anatomy, warm-bloodedness and cold-bloodedness cleverly combined reveal a different standard of animal species, apart from the whole plan of creation. Because God, when created the animals, He created them separately, not mixed up. The idea is that their developer, by the word developer I mean Satan, was trying to equip them with the best of reptiles, mammals, and birds at the same time and make them a dominant species above all others. And then the consequence will be destruction. The following slides will talk about Lucifer, who was Lucifer, his power, his capability. He was able to do it. If mankind, if our scientists today can do cloning, can do DNA manipulation, Satan was very well able to do it in the beginning because he is far more intelligent than any of us. Okay? So, folks, I wrote this book, and since then I have been trying to get this book in the media. I had the support of Dr. Brown at Atlantic Union College. He gave me his support. He's the head of the natural science department at Atlantic Union College. And he read the book. The book has some parts in it that talks about biology, because talking about DNA, you have to talk about biology. And he read the book and said, it's okay, it's fine, it's perfect. So I have that recommendation. Recently, I sent a copy of the book to Andrews University, to Dr. John T. Baldwin. He's a theology professor. And he got the book and sent me a letter saying that the book was good and he was curious about the book and he would read it. So this book is the kind of literature that we must have it, you know, because it doesn't talk only about dinosaurs, but talks about salvation, talks about Jesus Christ, talks about the great controversy, how Lucifer rebelled against God and came to Earth to create the dinosaur to destroy humankind. So it's a kind of, it's a tiny particle of the great controversy. Shows how the enemy has been bent since the beginning in destroying God's creation. May God bless us all and help us to understand this project. And whoever can help, please join hands and help me with this. Thank you. Amen.